And welcome, everybody here in Twitch chat, and everybody on YouTube for some Diana's Fortune. That's right, we're going to be playing a Nightfall Diana deck. Going on over to Bilgewater, which we have done before with Fizz, but this time we are going to be going over there for Miss Fortune. And we're going to be leveling up Miss Fortune, hopefully, having our scout attackers. We got a couple island navigators, plus we can get some extra attacks with Citrus Courier. Another cool thing about our deck is we got Jack the Winner, this brand new epic from Call of the Mountain. This is a fun card to play, so I wanted to play this one. This is just fills up our 5 mana slot with 3 of these, and of course we got 3 Riptide Rexes at the top end. 2 Spray Fins in here. I've been really liking Spray Fin plus Pale Cascade. That's just like a treasure trove of value there. So we're either getting Pale Cascade, Make It Rain, or maybe Warning Shot with that card. And Warning Shot we can use not only for Riptide Rex in this deck, but we can also use this as a Nightfall enabler. So let's give this a try. We're going to play Diana's Fortune. We're going to go play 5 games over in Ranked. I just realized it says that we're at 4. I thought that we were at like 1 before. Did I level? Are we in a different, like, is this like diamond now? Like we were in platinum before, now this is diamond? Maybe? I'm not sure. I probably should know. Alright, Morris Edge Wani Gangplank. You have to like playing against Bilgewater these days, because there's a lot of Bilgewater. Do we just keep both Make It Rains? Maybe we do. Maybe just keep both. What's up, Cosmo? Alright, we're both just passing turn. We'll play our Miss Fortune, they'll play their Petty Officer. There hasn't really been a game in ever that Bilgewater deck doesn't have Petty Officer on turn 3. That's never happened. Alright, good blocker with the Shadow Fiend. We'll just let this go. So yeah, I think we're just going to double Make It Rain. I'm 2-for-1-ing myself, but keeps them from getting easy plunder turned on, and we don't really have great use for this mana anyway.
Never stop shooting.
Need to turn on that plunder.
Set sail.
Are gonna take the 4 damage. Gotta be. Okay, I was gonna say it's gotta be Gangplank, but I guess it could be Jack the Winner as well. Sleep with the fishes.
Time to finish this.
My thoughts exactly.
Nagakaburos, guide us.
Picks? That's my first time I've gotten picks with one of those. I can hush this thing and then we take one less damage. That doesn't really seem like that's worth it. Give my supported ally +2/+1 this round, so we can make Island Navigator a 4/5. If we want to do that. I think that's worth it.
Make them bleed. Let's get to it. Who likes their odds, eh?
All right, maybe the sleep with the fishes wasn't worth it. I'll admit, maybe it was not worth it.
You and me, let's go.
Ooh, I love the citrus courier, though. Love that. Because that can potentially level up Misfortune this turn.
Always forward.
I'm gonna
they
catch you.
Don't get to... Yeah, as I say, they don't get to kill the Island Navigator. Now that 4-2, they can attack multiple times. Look at... See, Pix does damage. Who says Pix doesn't do any damage?
Love ya.
All right, so first attack.
Nothing like the stink of blood and sweat. Get to work.
Raise your weapon, Sunwind.
Whatever the cost.
What's that you got there?
I think we should have this.
Yeah, bud.
I think that's GG's. Scout. I think that's GG's. Scout plus Citrus Courier. Let's go. Go. Alright, 1-0 for Diana's Fortune.
Fortune smiles.
Didn't use our new Nightfall stuff too much, but we're still able to just use Misfortune with all those attacks. Playing against Taric. That's cool, we haven't played against Taric too much. Taric with Lee Sin. Interesting. We'll keep this starting hand and mulligan our 5-mana card. Go ahead and lead with the Duskbringer. Possibly I should mulligan Warning Shot also, I guess, because we have the Duskbringer that can give us the Dusk Petal to be able to get the Nightfall activated on Diana. Yeah, we can play this too. For how this has played out, I kind of wish I would have mulliganed Warning Shot, but we are pretty aggressive. Maybe the Warning Shot will get us that extra point of damage. Maybe our opponent will stabilize at 1.
No more hiding.
I'll just take the 4. What's up, Original Mars? Oh, dang. I will not get 4 damage in. We're using a Concussive Palm just to stop a 2-1 these days. Fortunately, I don't get the Attune mana. No, worst card to get with the Warning Shot. Okay, so we have 2 Warning Shots in our deck. So we can't get any more. That was the worst card to draw. We either draw Warning Shot, Make It Rain, or Pale Cascade.
Each life, a rare
and we joy. Wanted to draw all the rest of them. I guess I could have done that on the spray fin and had the spray fin survive. I don't want to really risk the spray fin though.
Damn. Oh, I missed it.
Hush is devastating again. Hush is always devastating.
Every wave is a
so Jack the Winner is probably better to play than Island Navigator, but I kind of like playing this Island Navigator where we can also have Diana. So like if they play something that's smaller that I can challenge with the Diana, we have that ability. Yes, Hush, you still get, even if your opponent has Spell Shield and you cast Hush on the unit with Spell Shield, you just get rid of the shield and you still create another Hush in hand so that if they do have a Spell Shield unit, you can have 6 mana, cast Hush, get rid of the Spell Shield, and then cast Hush again.
And here's where I'd paint my constellation.
Yeah, let that kill my 2-1. I don't know if I want to let that kill my 2-1. I don't really want to use Diana challenge on that, and I don't really want it to kill my 2-1. We just have, like, make it rain and all sorts of stuff like that. Alright, I guess we Diana challenge it.
Let's do this.
I agree, Turkey. It doesn't really make sense because the spell shield is supposed to negate that spell, so it doesn't really make sense of why the spell shield would, or why the Hush would create another copy. I agree, it doesn't.
Come, a new phase awaits.
Yay. Sorry. Decided just to play one because I think I'd probably rather play Jack the Winner than the second. I agree. So Slay says, I think negate does not stop like deny. But yeah, the wording is not amazing, but I agree with you. I guess negate does not stop like deny would. That wording could be better. I don't know exactly. If negate does not stop like deny, I mean, I don't know what negate does.
I promise the blood bath. Good to go.
Riptide Rex is still obnoxious. I feel bad for my opponent. I feel like the bad guy. Playing Riptide Rex. Right, okay, so if you think about Spell Shield negating Withering Whale, it negates the Withering Whale part that does the damage to the one unit with the Spell Shield, but the rest of the Withering Whale does like the damage to all the other things. So if we think about that with Hush, the Spell Shield would negate the part that says that the Hush silences that unit, but the rest of the Hush still goes through, and so it still creates another fleeting copy of Hush in hand. So that makes sense then. I don't know how you would like define negate then, as far as Spell Shield is concerned, how it negates a spell.
Come closer.
And that's kind of problematic that if you need to be able to define your cards and, like, your keywords on your cards. Negate, I guess, means cancel out anything that affects only this unit. Any part of the spell that... only the parts of the spell that affect this unit. None of these are good to play right now.
You won't suffer long.
Dang. I guess we're playing a 3-3. I should have played this Shade Stalker as just a 2-3 to block the 1-1, I guess. Especially how just knowing how this turn's gonna play out, I definitely wish I would have done that. It's an odd block. they have to have another Elise, like the champion spell for Elise. It's the only reason to, yep, that's the only reason to make that block.
You'll serve me one way or another.
Yeah, I don't like that wording either with negate. It's odd, for sure. Well, this was all awkward. So I was hoping they would do. Oh, what are you doing? Just blocking whoever. Come on. Block the card I tell you to block. It's gonna be really tough to stabilize at this point in the game, but we're going to be trying. They got some pretty fearsome units over there. Nah, looks like we did. That means they have another demolitionist in hand. Stalking Shadows is amazing, and you get to kind of pick and choose. You know, kind of get some selection there. Also, of finding like the really impactful card that you need. More Bilgewater. So let's draw a warning shot. Especially we have the attack token on turn 2 with the challenger. Warning shot. How about that? Sometimes a plan comes together, Cosmo.
Raise your weapon, Sunwood.
What's up, Mama Man? How's your stream been going? Hope life's going good. How are you enjoying facing Bilgewater? Like 3 out of 5 matches. Hope you're enjoying it. All right, got their 2/2 out of here for free. By for free, I mean for a warning shot. No.
Find me a flavoring lump.
Look, behind you, a three-headed monkey.
Alright, so I would like to play Duskbringer into Guardian. The problem with playing Duskbringer into Guardian is Twisted Fate. We do that, they go Twisted Fate, the game's over. If I attack, then we can get rid of this before Twisted Fate, but then they could have Make It Rain still. So it's, if I attack, we're good against Twisted Fate. Either way, Make It Rain is devastating. I think, okay. So we understand if I go Duskbringer Guardian, if they have Twisted Fate, the game's over, but I think this is still the best thing to do as far as actually winning the game, because I feel like if we just go to attacks, we are losing out on a lot of potential value. Okay, good. They did not play Twisted Fate, at least not yet. So the 3-2 blocks the 5-3, the 1-1 blocks the 2-1. Do I want the 1-1 blocking the 2-1? Yeah, I mean, that's just how it is. Good, good. Okay, off. You're off today. I went on a 13-game losing streak on stream yesterday. Dude, those are the worst. I've been there, man. I have been there, like, where you just cannot buy a win. Yeah, I've definitely been there. And I feel like that's easier to do in this game, have that kind of huge losing streak, that is, over a game like Magic, where I used to play. Because, like, with Magic, you'd have, like, people just get mana screwed, and you're just going to win games from people being mana screwed and not being able to play cards. But with this game, that's not really the case. Both players, like, you know, usually curve out pretty well, but sometimes your opponents just, you know, have better hands than you just all the time, and you're just never going to get, like, that. You're never going to get free wins. And so sometimes it just doesn't work out for you.
Our light grows brighter.
So the problem with going straight to attacks like I just did is we don't get to draw a card off of the Pale Cascade. But we're putting them down to one little life. So now we just need to draw warning shots. Warning shot through the heart. It's not too late. We could still draw one from Zapsprayfin.
I'm always up for a round or two.
I'm gonna just lead with the soldier. The block Twisted Fate. Wow, I'm pretty stunned. They used Arachnoid Sentry right there.
Keep up.
Looks like
Sprayfin makes it rain.
We live here.
These are all good emotes. I won't be a jerk. Alright, 3-1. Alright, but that was a good win. Playing the Crescent Guardians, you know, going that, like, on that turn 4, not being scared of the Twisted Fate, that was what really allowed us to win that game, I think, of, like, playing to win instead of playing not to lose. Now, we're playing against the deck that we did lose to, Noxus Shadow Isles. They're not playing Darius. We have the guard dogs over here looking out the window. The guard dogs.
Raise your weapon, Sunwood.
Yeah, probably just somebody going by on their, you know, mid-afternoon stroll.
Devotion to battle.
Maybe walking their dog. Yeah, tomorrow's supposed to be Rank Up Sunday. We've definitely had some poor Rank Up Sundays before, like I already talked about, of, like, losing streaks. That has definitely happened before.
In the shadows.
Who goes there? Alright, love Island Navigator here. Getting multiple attacks in. Oh, Citrus Courier, what a draw. And we get a free card. Wow, Island Navigator is great and gives us a free card. Let's see if the puppy likes Island Navigator. Look at that pupper. She's like, wow, what a card. Look at that one.
This is our way.
I should probably just not be on stream at all and just have dog cam instead. Probably a lot better. But yeah, Kordek, we have had a good day of climbing today. Nope. Let me draw a Riptide Rex. Pale Cascade is awesome.
Love ya.
I kind of want to attack with the Misfortune. So the Misfortune trades with Elise. But then if I do that, then, like, they don't have, like, they can stop 2 damage. They're going to take 4 total, and Elise is gone. I guess with Citrus Courier I shouldn't, but I want to. Want to. Oh, I should have. I mean, that's an Elise sprawling sensation. No, now they level up Elise. I should have traded. No, I definitely should have traded. Cygnus and Moonstalker. Unfortunately, Cygnus and Citrus Courier both cost 6, and it's turn 5. Get down with the Cygnus. Cool. You've made your— why is that 2-1 attacking?
Mother Moon, veil me. No one's the wiser.
Pretty sure this game's over. I mean, unless— if they cannot kill Misfortune, this game's over. It's not looking like they're killing Misfortune. So we're going to attack. Attack again. Citrus Courier, attack again. They're looking for their things that do damage. I guess if all three of these do 2 damage, they still lose. So both of these are a unit. They're the same unit. So we don't have to worry about you know, we don't need to worry about Decimate. Right, because obviously I could have played the Courier and healed my Nexus 3. But we can do that this next turn, because they can only— oh, I mean, they have 2 mana anyway. I guess we don't need to worry about Decimate with that also. I guess I wasn't even looking at mana. Yeah, they're dead. Yep, they should have pulled Misfortune in front of a 2-1. They're greedy. Alright, GG's. Dude, Citrus Courier has been pretty sweet. This is the second time we've used Citrus Courier to get a leveled up Misfortune attack. Turns out attacking 3 times in a turn is good. This is why we're playing Island Navigator instead of Petty Officer. G's to the G's. Oh, I was gonna emote.
That's how we do things in Bilgewater.
4-1. Good strong deck here with Diana's Fortune. Misfortune definitely looked really good. And you know, Diana and the, does its own Nightfall thing. I like Solari Soldier. I think Solari Soldier is better than Jagged Butcher, but that was definitely, you know, I was kind of, before playing this, I was like debating, do I want to play Soldier or Jagged Butcher? You know, which one of these two do I want to play? And I went with Soldier, and I'm pretty happy with that, because for the most part, we want this 1 mana card to be able to help turn on our Nightfall cards. And so if we're playing it early in the turn, like our first thing in the turn to be able to turn on the Nightfall stuff, I think we'd rather have the Soldier than the Jagged Butcher, because then at that point the Jagged Butcher is most likely going to be a 2-2 most of the time. We had 3 Jack the Winner, but we only played it like 1 time, but that card's cool. Island Navigator was great. Kind of want to get a third Island Navigator in here, because that card was great. Maybe over the Cygnus. Yeah, maybe we take out the Cygnus. I mean, Puddle of Mud wouldn't— is that Puddle of the Mud, that ban? Oh, they wouldn't like me getting the Cygnus out of here, but that could probably be the other Island Navigator. Card didn't seem too necessary. Awesome, but there we go. There's Diana's Fortune. Another good, strong Diana Bilgewater deck. Kind of like the Diana Fizz, but this one felt just as good. All right, those of y'all watching later on YouTube, hit that like button over there and feel free to leave those comments. Try this deck out yourself. Let me know how it goes for you. I always love seeing y'all's feedback over in YouTube. I value that highly. So Anyway, thank you so much for watching. Some Diana's Fortune, and I'll see you for the next video.